What's up, guys? In this short tutorial, I will show you some of the best settings to improve your Windows 11 performance. This should be quite an easy tutorial. Everything you need will be listed in the description below. First of all, you should make sure that Windows 11 is running the latest update. To do so, simply search for Update in your Start menu search and hit Enter. On this window, click on Check for Updates, and your OS will download any updates there might be available to you. Next, you should disable unnecessary programs from running in the background to improve your overall performance. To do so, go to the Start menu and search for Task Manager. Once the Task Manager opens up, navigate to the Startup tab. Here, you can see some of the programs and processes that automatically start running when you turn on your PC. You can disable some of these processes, which you don't frequently use, to decrease the boot time of your PC and help increase your performance. Simply right-click the application and select Disable. When this is done, I suggest deleting your temporary files from time to time. Temporary files are those files that are needed to run applications on your system. After using those programs, you can clear their temporary files to free up some space. This will help improve the overall performance of your Windows 11 PC. To do so, simply search for %temp% in your Start menu and hit Enter. A new folder will open up. You can safely delete all of the files in this folder. Some files might remain, so just leave them there. When this is done, type regedit in your Start menu search. Right-click the Registry Editor icon and select Run as Administrator. A new window will open up. Here, I suggest backing up your current registry in case you make a mistake during this tutorial. To do this, navigate to File and then Export. In your File Explorer, select a location where you want to save your backup to and click on Save. When this is done, navigate back to your registry editor and expand H key current user system and then select game config store. On the right hand side of this window, double click game DVR enabled. Change the data value to 0. Leave the base at hexadecimal and click on OK. When this is done, double click the game DVR FSE behavior mode and set this value to 2. Next, on the same registry editor window, navigate to HKeyCurrentUser, Software, Microsoft, Policy Manager, Default, Application Management, and here click on the Allow Game DVR folder. On the right hand side, double click value and make sure to set the value data to 0. You can now close this window and you should experience much more FPS and less stuttering while in-game. Next, I suggest following some common ways to improve your performance while using Windows 11. In your Start menu, search for Device Manager and open it up. On this window, you can expand your audio inputs and outputs, network adapters, USB connections, and so on. For each category, make sure that your main device's driver is up to date. Simply double-click the device you are using, in this case my headphones, and in the Driver tab, select Update Driver, and then search automatically for drivers. This will make sure that your device's driver is up to date. For your graphics card, I suggest using the GeForce Experience application if you're using an NVIDIA GPU, but you can also use the AMD driver suit. In the Drivers tab, simply click on Download and the application will automatically download and install the latest driver. Repeat this step at least a few times a year to make sure that you get the most out of your hardware. In the Home tab, you can access individual game settings, which can also be changed from here. Simply select Details for the game you intend to play. You will be presented with current in-game settings and with the optimal setting suggestion depending on your hardware. When selecting Optimize, GeForce Experience will apply the recommended settings to the game. You also have the option to use custom settings when selecting this wrench icon. Here, you can use this slider system to reduce some options and change your display resolution and display mode from here, in case you're using an abnormal screen resolution as I am. Next, open up your Task Manager by searching for it in your Start menu search. In order to reduce the CPU utilization from other programs, I suggest you end some programs from running in the background, which you don't need when using your PC. But make sure to only end programs from running which you know won't break your operating system. In your Task Manager, in the Performance tab, select Open Resource Monitor. In the Network tab, open the processes with network activity, and after a few seconds, you will see every process using your network connection. This might be your browser running in the background, Steam, or a download bottlenecking your connection. These processes will help you find out where network-related issues are coming from, and you can easily stop some processes from running if you wish to do so. Before improving your network connection, you should disable overlays from other applications, as these commonly cause issues while in-game and reduce your performance. Most applications have built-in settings to prevent any overlays from showing up. In your GeForce Experience application, navigate to your settings, and in the General tab, you can disable the overlay. To improve your network connection while in-game, make sure to use an Ethernet cable to ensure the best possible connection. In case you have to use a Wi-Fi connection, then restart your router or modem if you haven't done this in a while. To test your connection, I suggest using speedtest.net. Here, you can preview your average up and download speed, as well as your latency. You can also throttle the download speed of most applications, such as Steam, Epic Games, and the Adobe Creative Cloud. In your application settings, such as Steam, navigate to the Downloads tab. Here, enable the Limit Bandwidth to option to whatever you prefer. In my case, I will set this option to 8000 kilobytes per second. Right-click your desktop, click on Show More Options and select NVIDIA Control Panel to open it up. In the Adjust Image Settings with Preview section, make sure to set this option to Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings and apply your changes. In the Manage 3D Settings tab, you'll be able to make changes which have a big impact on your GPU's performance. Make sure to enable Image Sharpening if you can, and set the Sharpen value to 0.5 and Ignore Film Grain to 0.17. You should also enable the GPU Scaling option in case it's available to you. This will enable you to use custom resolutions, especially lower ones, for games which don't usually support it. Set Ambient Occlusion to Performance. Anisotropic Filtering to Application Controlled. Turn Anti-Aliasing FXAA to Off. Enable the Anti-Aliasing Gamma Correction option. Anti-Aliasing Mode should be set to Application Controlled. Anti-Aliasing Transparency should be turned off. CUDA GPUs should be set to All. The Dynamic Super Resolution option should be turned off, unless you prefer to upscale your in-game render resolution. For Low Latency Mode, set this option to On to get the most performance when playing games on your system. Unless you're running a low-end PC and you're unable to run games at 60fps, then set this option to Ultra. Turn the Max Framerate option off when using a system which has no issues running games on a normal framerate, as you can cap your FPS in most in-game settings anyway. If you suffer from low FPS, then you can manually cap your max framerate to your monitor's refresh rate to save some resources. Disable multi-frame sampled AA. Set the OpenGL rendering GPU to the GPU you are using, unless you are using multiple ones. Then set this option to auto select. Set the power management mode option to prefer maximum performance. Below, set the preferred refresh rate option to highest available. Enable shader cache as well as texture filtering, anisotropic sample optimizations. Set the texture filtering negative LOD bias to allow. Texture filtering quality should be changed to performance or high performance. In case you're using a low-end GPU, then set this option to high performance. Switch trilinear optimization to on. Threaded optimization should be set to auto. Triple buffering should be turned off. Turn off the VSync option. And lastly, set the virtual reality pre-rendered frames option to 1 and variable rate supersampling to off. Make sure to apply your changes. In the Change Resolution tab, select your monitor on the left-hand side. Select to use the highest resolution available to you, which is usually labeled as native. Also, make sure to use the highest refresh rate available to you. In case you don't see a high refresh rate option, even if your monitor is capable of high refresh rates, then make sure to use the right cable to connect to your PC. In my case, I need to use a DisplayPort to use the 144Hz refresh rate option. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.